First of all, if you're having troubles, you're not alone. But consider this. Is it because you're going too slow and not getting it? Or is it because you are going so fast, like that, you think, oh my gosh, I don't know if I can handle this. I don't know if I can handle this. Which is it? It may be that you're being so successful that you're starting to get the jitters and think, oh my God, I'm going to fail, I'm going to fail, I'm going to fail, I'm going too fast, I'm going too fast. I believe that's what happened with me coming off of yesterday, which was just an incredible breakthrough into this high kind of mental functioning. And then today, back to normal, and I'm saying, whoa, I'm a failure, I'm a failure. What happened? How come I can't stay there? Maybe, you know, I'm seeing it and I just say, wow, and I take a step back, you know, two steps forward, one step back. Maybe I'm not failing. I sort of felt like that today, like just I'm a total failure. I can't do anything right. I'm never going to succeed. This is just horrible. Just a super depressed day. And then I said, no, wait. Just a minute. Not so fast here. Not so fast. Maybe I'm succeeding almost too much. And I'm trying to like, wow, wait a minute. Let me think, like, do I really want to succeed that much? I believe that's a more accurate depiction of the situation. So I made a video prior to this one, and it was, you know, it was okay. But it wasn't terrific. If I can pick up the train of my thought again. Sure, that just saying, considering that I was made a video before this and it was okay, but it wasn't good enough. I said, no, I can do better than that. I can do better than that. So I lay down on my bed and took a rest, and then I kind of was thinking, what do I need to do? What do I need to do? What do I really need to do? And I can tell you that after the great breakthrough yesterday, I was tinkering with some slideshow software online. That does these incredible slideshows. I was getting so interested. It's like, wow. But something in the back of my mind said, no, this is not it. You know this isn't it. And I was feeling like getting pulled into this. I say, no, these images, fancy flying images around and stuff. Been there, done that. This is not it. Doesn't matter if you do it with you saints there or whatever. This is not it. We're better than that. We can go farther than that. We're way more advanced than that. So I said, okay, I decided this morning I'm not going to do that. So I said, well, what do I do? And then it came to me, hey, why not just let go of all your valuing, all your scripts? Why not just let everything go off script right now? And much to my surprise, I felt like, yeah, that's a good idea. I think that's what I want to do. And it seemed like not a problem. I said, what? Wow, that's super advanced. And so, but I felt like, sure, why not? So hello, I'm not, you know, failing. I just haven't totally succeeded yet. It takes perspective and it takes patience. I know it's going to be incredibly difficult at times. Like today. Today I just felt like dying. Why don't I just die? I'm never going to succeed. And meanwhile, the world is just going to hell. Absolutely going to hell, which is true, very true. The valuing of this world is going to hell. And yet you have to look at it and say, wait a minute, maybe the cup's half full and getting fuller all the while. And you think, oh my gosh, what happens if it overflows? What do I do? And you panic. There's a panic thing that sets in. So I decided, you know what, that's probably the situation. In my case, it's probably the situation. I'm not failing, I'm succeeding beyond anyone's wildest dreams, actually. And that's what makes it tough. So I said, what can I do in a video here? What can I do in a video that can help anyone? What I call it is a ministering smelling salts. So we come out of our coma, like we're almost out, like we need just a little smelling salts to wake us up. What is it that's really effective? What can I do that's really effective here to help out? And I decided, yeah, there's something I can do. I can focus on this letting go of valuing. This letting go of valuing. Now, to help us do that, there happens to be a book that I've been reading a little bit recently. I just bought it like about a week ago. It's this book right here, Journey Beyond Words, Dr. Brent Haskell. I first bought this book in 1994. That's when it was first published, 1994. Walked into a bookshop, didn't know about it, and I just saw this book, Journey Beyond Words, what's this? And I said, wow, I like this. So I studied it for a year straight, from 94 to 95, and then I set it down. And then I got involved at that point in all sorts of fancy graphics, fancy videos, fancy computer work, and went into about like a 15-year phase of that, thinking that I was preparing for the advent of the great masters to return to the planet and all of this stuff. Well, that's a long story, but it was a disaster. And there's still an enormous push to try and hook me into that. Hook me into that. And I've gone over in other videos to stay away from that. Big time trouble. Big time trouble. To say the very least. So, just about a week ago, I happened to be in a bookstore with my family members, and they wanted to get a book, and so I ended up just walking around the store, and I came across this book on the bookshelf. I just said, wow, look at that, that's an old friend. And I said, just let me get it, I'm gonna get my old friend, why not? And so I've been reviewing it, just seeing what's it like after I stopped in 95, it's been almost 20 years, really, since I've read the book. Actually, I bought a copy, I misplaced it like 10 years ago. I can't find it, I don't know what happened to it. Anyway, it's an old friend, and I went over it, and I said, wow, I really am still resonating with this. And I really get it pretty well, the whole thing, what's being said here. Which is good. It means I've made some progress over those 20 years. You hope so, but you never know. Okay, so in my review of this material, I found it to be, again, just incredibly, incredibly great. But very condensed, of course, and offering solutions that, you know, it's like, here is the solution, and it's right there. It's like, wow, you know, it's a very strong cup of coffee, as it were. Nevertheless, I've taken it to heart and said, yeah, because I found that all the considerations I've been doing for so long, you know, really fit in and very much go in this direction. I very much agree with what's being said. And for the most part, in other parts, I think like, wow, that's really, can I really, it's so advanced, right? Well, this, I ask, what is the most direct time-saving shortcut we can do really right now? What is the real answer? And there is an answer for us. There is an answer. I'm gonna boost this up a little bit. There is a time saver that we can use. There most definitely is. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about this, and we'll get into it. It's very similar to what I said in the video, off script. Let everything go off script. Let everything simply go off script. It's actually, that is what it is, but Jesus uses slightly different terminologies. And this book was supposedly dictated by Jesus to Dr. Brent Haskell. I'll tell you, whoever dictated it is our true self. Our true self dictated this. So call it what you want. It is simply spot on, simply spot on. And I'm not saying for anybody to go out and buy the book or anything like that, because keep in mind that I spent about 15 plus years studying A Course in Miracles before I came across this book, because I started A Course in Miracles in 1978, came across this book in 1994. So I had this tremendous buildup before I came across this book. I don't know how easy it would be for anybody just to, you know, come just read this directly. It might be quite difficult to truly take it in. And of course, like I said, it's been 20 years since I first came across this book, and I'm still working on this material. It is very condensed. It is a shortcut. And of course, in our valuing of the world, we are frightened to set our valuing down, because as Jesus says, we think there'll be nothing there. It'll be our death. And what he said he showed us 2,000 years ago, it most certainly is not our death. You set the body down, it is not our death. And so let me take a look at this. The remedy that we need right now, the remedy that we need is to quickly, without any more delay, realize our true nature. Realize the vision of oneness. Realize the holy vision of oneness. To free ourselves from all this valuing of trying to make imagination real, which is all that this is. It's trying to make imagination real and reality imagination. So we need a technique, something to focus on that can make this, that will enable us to do it now. To do it now. We don't want to get sucked into another cycle, which is what's happening, like a black hole sucking us into a fourth dimensional cycle here, which is really incredibly time delaying. And the thought of it just makes me shudder. It just makes me shudder. So there is a technique. There most certainly is a technique. And that is to, as I say, go off script. And Jesus says, let go of your valuing. And he says, now hear me very well. Do not think that you will let go of the imaginings as the result of your struggle and your effort. For in your struggle and your effort, you but further the imagined reality of your illusion. In a sentence then, to achieve salvation, merely do this. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. And that is all. Truly, that is all. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Okay? Simple. There's the shortcut. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. That is literally what we need to do, and actually what we can do. I have spoken to you many weeks of your values and your valuing. Indeed, it is your valuing of the illusion, of the vain imaginings you call this world, and your life and yourself, small s. It is the valuing of all of this that keeps you from relaxing your mind, releasing your thoughts, and letting them go. Very, very true, isn't it? This is the struggle. This is why I've spent 20 years after first coming across this book, and I still haven't done it, although I've realized that there have been certain thought complexes that have left me, most definitely. Like the whole thing that seems to be crumbling and starting to blow away in the wind. And maybe if a breeze comes up, it will all blow away in the wind, as a matter of fact. And I just have to make sure I don't chase after it. Just let it go. Just let it go. It is your valuing that tells you in your thinking that if you let go, you will surely die. I tell you today, as I said 2,000 years ago, he who will lose his life shall find it. And this is exactly what I meant. To let go of your thoughts, to release your mind, to relax your total being, is simply to realize that none of it has any effect on what you really are as the Son of God. So when we let go of all our valuing of what we are, we will find what is left is what we actually are, that is completely independent, not dependent on valuing whatsoever. All right? So, and when you have relaxed your mind, what then must you do to achieve your salvation? The answer is this: absolutely nothing. For your salvation is not to be achieved. It is already yours. And your only task is to let go for the one instant it takes for that certainty to well up within your being, and then your awareness beyond the level of your thinking, your awareness of what you are as the Son of God, as co-creator of all that is, shall well up within your being with such power that you will never be the same, for you will be free. And I have said often in the text, all it takes is the little willingness. Truly, you need do nothing. And the reason is this: your true nature is. You cannot change it. You cannot even toss it aside. All you can do is use your power to imagine that you are something different. And as you let go of the values which tell you that your thinking and your imaginings are real, as you let go of these values even for an instant, then automatically, without effort, the memory of your true nature shall be there. It is not that the memory will return, for it is already there. Only your imaginings hide it from you. So once again, I have said often in the text, he refers to A Course in Miracles, all it takes is your little willingness. Truly, you need do nothing. And the reason is this: your true nature is. You cannot change it. You cannot even toss it aside. All you can do is use your power to imagine that you are something different. And that is exactly what we have done for so long, is trying to imagine that we are something different. And more than that, we're trying to imagine that we're becoming something different. Because we really aren't something different, right? And we know that. We know that because our true nature is still with us, within us, right? We're still here. So we say, well, that's okay, because we're actually becoming something different. And all of this, and work on the body, trying to perfect the body, trying to protect a perfect form, and protect it also, our valuing, is the belief that our body, at once be perfected, that the body will realize that it is God. It is God. And the only reason why it hasn't realized this yet is because we haven't perfected it. So in our imaginings, we're trying to continue to perfect the form, perfect the form until it reaches a point which we believe is mythical, magical, end of the rainbow point, where the body will be so perfect, it will then be able to realize that it is real, it is reality, it is perfection, it is God. This is a hoped for point in the future that we are all working towards, collectively working towards with our imagination, trying to work on this world. We say the body, the surroundings are not good enough for the body. Let's plant more flowers, let's plant more trees, let's build more beautiful homes, let's have more beautiful things, let's have more beautiful images and music, and let's feed the body, feed the body, feed the body. And we're waiting for that magical, mythical moment when our odyssey will be over, where the body suddenly realizes, oh my gosh, I am life, I am truth, this is reality, I am God. We're waiting for that point. And I'll tell you this, that point never comes. We're waiting for nothing. We're weightlessly waiting for nothing. The weightlessness is within us. Our true self is not waiting for anything, actually. It already is. It's there. So we are afraid of letting go of this becoming, thinking that if we let go of our becoming, we will be nothing. We will not know that we are God. We're already one with God. It's our vain imaginings of becoming that is obscuring this fact from us. And this is just what Jesus says in a shorthand. You know, this is very shorthand. What I've tried to do over the last 20 years is try and develop to everyone what the shorthand is all about. But ultimately, we come back to the shorthand and say, this is all we need, just this shorthand. We get it. We get it. Let go. Relax your mind. Let go of all your thoughts. It's that simple. It's that simple. So once again, to reiterate, relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. And don't chase after them. That's the key. Don't chase after them. So I'm adding that. I'm adding a little license there to add. Relax your thought, relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go, and don't chase after. Now, is this pie in the sky? Now, what's pie in the sky is waiting for the body to reach this mythical, magical point where it realizes that it is the creation of God, that it is the true creation. See, that's what's magical and mythical and will never happen. That's pie in the sky. That is pie in the sky. As far as relaxing our mind, releasing our thoughts and letting them go and not chasing after them, we can do that. That is something we can do. There are some who have done it throughout history. Never more important than to do it now, that is for sure, because of this delaying cycle that is becoming ultra intense. It already is ultra intense, but it's going to speed up now, where we, with valuing of the body, will be demanded of everyone on this planet that they all get on going on the same page, pulling in the same direction. That will be demanded of everybody. So we need to relax our mind, release our thoughts, and let them go, and don't chase after them. Now, it's not pie in the sky, but it may be easier said than done. Because as Jesus said it, we believe if we do that, we will die. No, we will not. What will be let go of is just this waiting for the body to get it. If the body does, it'll never get it. Because how can you get a lie? How can you make a lie true? We're waiting for the body to see a lie and say, ah, this lie is true. See, we're trying to fashion some power that makes lies true, that reverses the direction of creation, enables us to create separately from the will of God. This will never happen. Will never, ever happen. I don't care how much yoga anybody does or prayer for this or all the valuing and thinking and strategizing. How does Jesus put it? He puts it, all of your struggle and your effort. See, in your thinking, you cannot do it. Do not think that you will let go of the imaginings as a result of your struggle and your effort. For in your struggle and your effort, you but further the imagined reality of your illusion. Okay, so it is all of the efforts that we're making as far as trying to get it conceptually, etc. It's still blocking us. We need to relax our mind, let our thoughts go. Relax the mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Relax our mind, release our thoughts, and let them go, and don't chase after them. So we do need to see that this is truly the goal. This is truly the goal. This is truly the shortcut of all shortcuts. And start focusing in on this, as we have been doing in the videos. Actually, all these videos I've done have been going in this direction, going in this direction, because at the back of my mind I realized there is this shortcut, and it came to me as going, let everything, give permission for everything to go off script, everything to go off script. If that's the case, then what is left on script? Our true nature is always on script. You see, our true nature can't go off script. So if you give everything permission to go off script right now, Okay, everything off script right now. What is it that remains on script? That which remains on script is our true nature, is our true identity, is the one relationship, is the will of God. The will of God can't go off script, you see. But all our valuing can. We have the power to send it all off script, as a matter of fact. Which is another way of saying, relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go, and don't chase after them. It's just saying the exact same thing. So, do we have to do this instant? No, we don't have to do it this instant. Am I going to do it right now? Probably not. But in the very talking about it and focusing on it, we start this process of acceptance within, saying, you know what, this is what I'm going to do. I am going to do this. And then we begin to adjust all our efforts accordingly. The effort is simply to relax our mind, release our thoughts, and let them go, and don't chase after them. And we start to get familiar, our comfort zone moves into that objective, moves in that direction of that objective. For when we do this, what remains, our true nature remains, which is not dependent on our thinking or our imagining, which was what valuing as it is. When we value something, we're really creating our own death. We are trying to create our own death. We're saying that without this value, I cannot live. I am nothing. But it's not us that established our own value. It is God that created us and established our value. Our true value is not at the mercy of our thinking or our imagining. At all. Not at all. And it affects it not in the slightest bit. All our thinking and imagining does not affect our intrinsic value in the slightest bit, to the slightest degree. Never will, never will, never will. So the fact of the matter is we're trying to be separate. We're trying to be separate from God, create separately from God through imagining, trying to create true value through our imagining, which is impossible. Our imagining is how we experience, but our true value is the one experiencing. So we cannot use our imagination to create a new reality, a new self. And I believe that Jesus remarks on this. Here's something that is said, very important. You have been given all power within the universe, quote-unquote universe, I would say, because what we're seeing, what we think we're seeing is not the real universe at all, but we're just using words here, it's fine. You have been given all power within the universe as co-creator with God, but there is one power you do not have, and that is the power to change what you truly are. This world is a reflection of the power of what you can imagine. Indeed, it oftentimes usually seems so real to you. This is but a reflection of the power of your imagining. But your imagining cannot change the truth of what you are. Okay, this world is a reflection of the power of our imagining. But what he's saying is we're trying to imagine that we can change what we are. This world is a reflection of our desire to change what we truly are. And we do not have that power. We don't have that power. So we're not giving up any power when we relax our mind, let go of our thoughts, relax our mind, release our thoughts, and let them go. Don't chase them. We're not giving up any power. We don't have the power to change what we are. We do not have it. So again, it may seem like a far-off goal to be able to do this. But it may not be as far off as you think. The more of us that do this, the easier it gets for others, as a matter of fact. There may be a 100 monkey sort of situation going on where enough of us do this, others will say, hey, that's not so difficult. I can do that. it's trying to go first or second. I mean, trying to go not first or second, but trying to go, you know, early on, that seems to be so difficult because you look at the world and you just don't see anyone doing this, really. And You think, wow, maybe it's like incredibly difficult. Not really. Not really. Fortunately, Jesus showed us that this is what needs to be done, and we can do it. But I mean, there's been thousands of years, and people have been chewing on it, thinking, wow, can I really do this? Can I really do this? So I believe we can do it. I know we can do it. And so for sure we will do it. And how it plays out, if someone else does it right now, great, wonderful. Do it. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go, and don't chase after them. And what will be left is what we truly are. Totally powerful. Just not having the imaginary power to change what we truly are, which we've never had in the first place. So we're not losing anything when we let go of our thoughts, relax our mind, let go of our thoughts, release our thoughts and let them go, don't chase after them. We're not losing anything, because what we've been trying to hold on is our valuing of our imagined capacity to create separate from God. And we don't have that capacity. We cannot change what we are. So there isn't any real valuing in this world, because this world is designed to as a process to accomplish what can never be accomplished, actually. Now, once we experience what we truly are, then the world, we know the world can't do anything to us. So it's still here. We can walk here and function here just fine, but we will know the world can't do anything to us. We will know it for sure. You know, the spell will have been broken. Once the spell's broken, then you can still hang out, but you know there's no more spell. You're not having a spell cast on you anymore. So we relax our mind. We release our thoughts and we let them go. We don't chase after them. We don't worry about where they go. They go into the ocean. Let them go into the ocean. Our thoughts are flying away like an umbrella on the beach. We're on the beach and there's an umbrella, and this beautiful breeze comes and picks up the umbrella and carries it across the beach, scudding across the sand. It's going out to the ocean. And you know, you just look at it, you just say, bye bye, umbrella. I don't need you anymore. And just let it go. Let the umbrella go out into the ocean. Don't chase after it. What I feel is the toughest part is the last part, and don't chase after it. Because what happens is when we start to release stuff, we say, oh, I can do this. But how do I get my thoughts back? How do I get them back? You know, how do I chase after them? How do I catch them? Oh my gosh, all the animals are out of the barn. You know, how do I get them back in the barn? You don't need to. They'll wander back to the barn of their own accord, but now you will not be deceived by them, you see. Your functioning will remain, but not deceived anymore. Whatever thoughts you need will come to you to function, and then they'll be self-released when you don't need them to function. So your mind is no longer under the spell of all your thoughts and concepts and ideas about yourself, about what you are. See, all of this is ideas, concepts, and thoughts about what we are. And what we are is created by God and sustained by God. It doesn't need our thoughts and concepts about it in order to be what it is. Now, again, I've been looking at all this fancy digital effects stuff, trying to say, can I put on something that's really powerful? But I really feel that doing something like this live with somebody here, a person talking about this, is the most powerful way to go about it. There's something about just viewing these images just with their fancy effects and everything. To me, it's not good. It's not good. It's a lot of razzle-dazzle, but I think it's way more potent to actually listen to a talk. Way more potent. There's much more spontaneity to it. There's much more aliveness to it. There's much more being conveyed than some beautiful picture of a sunset coming in, you know. It lacks a lot, which is why they put all these special effects, you know. It doesn't convey as much. It really doesn't. Even if you use pictures of saints, etc., it just doesn't get down to the nitty-gritty of communicating. There's so much more nuance in a situation like this. I mean, I get tired of looking at my face. I don't even watch the videos because. But there is potency to the sharing in this way that it simply is not there. Even in books, it's not there. It is more potent, in my opinion, to do this than even to read books. Because we're communicating on the level of where we are right here, realizing we're not alone. Others are struggling with this. Talking about the struggle, our reactions to it, is something organic in our lives that we're talking about. It's not just a book on a shelf. We are struggling with this and desperately trying to reach this, and at times feeling very despondent about not being able to do this. So I said the tough point is, and don't chase after them. Because we feel that all these thoughts are, we need them to become what we want to be. And so we think, oh, I've lost all my thoughts. Somebody else will get all these thoughts and concepts, and they will then benefit from all those the thoughts and concepts that I've made. No, they won't. They know they won't. Sure, they may pick up on all those thoughts, etc. But all those thoughts are useless. All our imaginings trying to change what we truly are useless. They're useless. They're useless at the level of thought, at the level of vision, of spiritual vision. They can be a mirror, a backdrop, a mirror upon which the vision of holiness can be reflected. Okay, that's the way to use them, the only use they can be given. That's it. So I will try to keep working here, and we'll start doing some workshops, some workouts, some actual focusing in on this is to relax our mind, release our thoughts, and let them go. Now this seems very like meditation or guided, you know, meditation, like I'm trying to do this. What I found is in using practicing and exercising, it's very helpful. And then let it all go, and just in a moment you may be resting somewhere and it'll suddenly come into your mind like, hey, I can do this. Or maybe when you're sleeping you'll do it. We can't force it to come about, really. The more we struggle to force it, the more we're reinforcing in some way. It's relaxing our mind. Relaxing our mind, releasing our thoughts and letting them go. So we should not think that we're trying to force this to happen in our practicing. What we're doing is we're gaining familiarity. We're dealing with the continuity problem. We have this continuity issue, and we need to talk about it. We need to feel comfortable and say, yeah, you know, that's not such a big problem. I thought it was a huge thing. It's really not that big of a deal. Don't go chasing after them. Just let it go. Doesn't matter where they go, because it has no effect on what you are. Where they end up, where the leaves end up, when the wind's blowing them, doesn't matter. We don't need to know. It has no relevance to us whatsoever. Okay. So to recap, we need a shortcut. We need to do what actually works. We need to know what actually works. We now know what actually works. I vouch for this. I know that to relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. And there's nothing more else that we need to do, because as the leaves blow away, all this dust blows away, underneath it is the solid block of seamless golden identity that we truly are. And it's just, we see it, we say, oh, yeah, it's there. So this is the shortcut. And however you want to put it, whatever words you're saying, go off script, it is the shortcut. It is what works. It is what works right now. We can do it. We can do it. We can do it. We will do it. It's only a question of when. And so we're trying to shorten the delay as much as possible. So I will, in a little while, I will see what I can do to help us keep focusing in on this ever more carefully, ever more intensely. There's no question that some of the fear within me has worn off. There's no question about it. Because as I thought about doing this, I didn't really feel very much fear at all. I kind of said, yeah, okay, let's do that. I was like, huh? Wow. Last time I checked, I was kind of fearful of it. And now, no, it's been worn away. So doing the exercises, the practices, focusing in on this discourse, wears away the fear. It does wear it away, even if we can't quite calibrate and measure exactly, you know, how much is how fast and all this scientific nonsense. We don't need it. It's being worn away. It's melting. The ice cube is melting. And we just have to keep melting it for sure. For sure. Because the situation in this world, again, is, I would say, terrible beyond description, actually. You know, I don't even want to talk about it. It's so terrible. That's how terrible it is. I just want to get free of it. Because it is an intense refocusing on our valuing of this world, which is really valuing our death, which is trying to bring about our death. We're trying to change what we are, which is really, you know, we have all these deaths. We're trying to say, you see, it's working. You see, it's working. You see, it's working. So we really have to save a lot of time, save a lot of delay, and get with it. So we will do just that. And don't despair. If you're having a downtime, don't despair. You may be making more progress than you realize. You may be making tremendous progress, and you just have to catch your breath a little bit. Catch your breath. But this is nothing tricky about this. There's nothing tricky. It's just there's a certain inner reassurance that gradually builds up, builds up, and builds up, and builds up. That's all. That's all. So relax your mind. Release your thoughts. Let them go, and don't chase after them. And we will then, it will be revealed just automatically, without any effort on our part, what we are. What is it that can never go off script? That will be on script for us, for sure. Okay? Very great. That's it.